Sabi ko sa asawa ko, how can I be a better husband to you? Ano sabi niya sa akin? Ay, wag na, magagalit ka lang. Yun yung sagot ko, ay, ba't ako magagalit? Yun yung una namin expression. So at least, di ba, natututo ka dahan-dahan. Kasi tinry ko rin eh. No, hindi pala madali. Di ba? Pero, little by little, you're growing. Kahit sa mga anak ko, how can I be a better father to you? Like, minsan, parang, ito ka. Parang gusto ko sila lahat palayasin. Nung una. Pero, little by little, you're growing. Minsan, tinanong sila, how can I be a better father? Mag-improve ka na. Di ba? Sarap pakinggan. Pero, siyempre, marami pa. Kaya lang, not little by natututunan mo, nga, no, I'm not perfect. If I am truthful, if I am willing to speak the truth in love, then I must be willing to listen and hear truth in love. Tama? Even if their motives are not really loving, but at least if it's truthful, you understand, I want to become better for Jesus. Sabi si S. Lewis, sabi niya, to love at all is to be vulnerable. Love anything and love your heart will certainly be wrong and possibly be broken. If you want to make sure of keeping it intact, you must give your heart to no one. Wrap it carefully, round with hobbies and little luxuries. Avoid all entanglements. Lock it up safe in the casket or coffin of your selfishness. Kung ayaw mo maging vulnerable, ayaw mo masaktan, ayaw mo, sabi ganoon din, itago mo na lang yan, ilibing mo na lang yan. But in that casket, safe, dark, motionless, airless, it will change. It will not be broken. Sabi niya, it will become unbreakable, impenetrable, irredeemable. The alternative to tragedy, or at least to the risk of tragedy, is damnation. The only place outside heaven where you can be perfectly safe from all the dangers and perturbation of love is hell. Kaya ang sabi ni C.S. Lewis, wala kung ganyan ang gusto mo, wala. It's like hell. You're hiding from yourself, from your selfishness. Kasi real love, you're willing to speak, you're willing to tell the truth, and you are also willing to accept the truth.